trying a new format of video for the channel because I've done so many videos now for the past couple of years where I've been really high in editing, trying to make cool transitions. But I think the real point that I want to get across from these videos is the actual information that I'm relaying to you as one music producer to the other. And sometimes I think these sorts of things can be a distraction. So this new template that I'm going for with these videos is I'm just sitting down and I'm talking to you and having a conversation, as I feel like that could be potentially the best way to get any information across I can to you as possible on this channel. As you know, for the longest time, this channel has been about helping music producers start to make money for their craft, whether it just be like a small income on the side or trying to go full-time freelance as a music producer. With a little bit of bias towards the beat making side of making money recently in the past couple years, that's just how it's been on the channel. But as you know, I'm always trying to discuss multiple ways to earn an income as a producer, and I wanted to take this video to have a talk for you if you're someone right now who, let's just say you've left university, or maybe you want to start having a career in music, maybe you just make music for fun, but you want to start trying to figure out how you can put your foot into the industry and start making money for yourself as a music producer. Well, I wanted to use this video as a chance to sit down, talk to you, and tell you a little bit about how you can do that. Hopefully me rambling on kind of ties everything together in a way that makes sense to you, where if you're someone you don't know where to start, hopefully by the end of this video you will know where you need to start and what you need to do to be able to start making an income as a producer. And I also want to be completely honest with you, because I don't want to be one of these channels where it's all clickbaity and trying to tell you how you can make money overnight as a music producer, because we all know that is not the reality. So let's just debunk that right away. If you're someone who wants to be a music producer, the first thing that I'm going to say you're going to have to do is to be willing to stick at this for a long time, be consistent, and really refine on what your niche is. Now, again, that's a really basic explanation of what you need to do as a music producer, but I just want to get out of the way as a disclaimer straight away, because if you're not willing to do that, then you're going to find it very hard to stay motivated over a long period of time to actually start making money with your music. Anyway, now I've said all that, let's actually start discussing a couple of ways where you can start to make money with your music and how we can figure out how you are going to make money for yourself as a music producer. And for the love of God, I do not want anyone in the comment section saying, oh, it shouldn't be about the money when you make music. You get into it because you want to make money with your music, okay? That's just the reality of it. Yes, you may enjoy music, and hey, I've been a full-time music producer now for the past couple of years, and I still enjoy making music since the day I started. That doesn't have to do anything with the fact that you should be focusing on trying to make money with your music if you want to pursue it as a full-time career. But yeah, I just feel like I had to say that, because I just know one person in the comment is going to be saying it's not about the money, it's about the music. It is about the music, but we're talking about how you can make money with music, okay? The first thing I really want to talk about is the fact that when I first got into making music, I didn't know how I was actually going to make any sort of an income. I went to university, I got a degree in music production, and that did absolutely nothing at helping me try to actually make money for music. Now, how do you actually want to make money with your music? Because there is different avenues that you can go down. Yes, one of the biggest bits of advice I would give you is to have multiple streams of income as a music producer. But when you're first starting out, you need to be focusing on that one income and doing really well at that one income. That's what I did, because if you can build one up and get that self-sustaining, then that will give you the time to start something new and start to build that multiple streams of income. Now, some streams of income are a lot more attainable than others. I think one of the really hard ones nowadays is the streaming income. I feel like that isn't even in the producer bracket. That's more the music artist, but some producers make music to release it still, and you can call yourself a producer even though you're releasing music technically as an artist. But that is something that takes a lot of investment. You need to invest in content, you need to invest in ads to be able to find and target your audience and get a loyal fan base growing, and that can take years. And even then, like, that's not really focusing down the producer route, because the main money in that is through merch sales and doing live gigs to promote your music as well. So again, streaming income is a really hard one to attain. Not impossible though, as we've seen from producers like Beautiful Beats, who has millions of monthly streams on his music. It is possible, but it's just personally, it's not the route that I've gone down, and I do think there's a very small percentage of success with that. So just keep that in mind, that if music streaming is something you feel like you want to do, maybe don't put that at the top of your priorities straight away. Now, one source of income which I talk about a lot on the channel is beat making. If you're someone who has a lot of productions that you made on your hard drive, you definitely should be getting into that. And it was something I actually wasn't made aware of till a couple of years ago. Beat making, basically, you'll be making an instrumental and you can upload it onto beat sites such as BeatStars, Airbit, or Soundy. And people can buy a license to distribute that beat with a song they've written over it on major streaming platforms. You make money not only from the license fee, but also from a 50-50 publishing split, depending on what contract you've got. I could get into that in a whole other video, but it's a very good way to start making a passive income with beats that you've made. And once you've made the beat, it is an asset for the foreseeable future because you can get it sold over and over and over again. But that's why beat making is such a good income as a music producer. Now, the big downside to beat making is it does take a long time to get going. And there's the whole comment that's thrown around saying it's an oversaturated market. It's not, but it does take time. Again, you'll be looking at the best part of a year to get the ball rolling with this at all, to get any sort of a part-time income. And if beat making is something you're interested in, then I highly recommend that you smash the subscribe button right now, because I do a lot of videos on how to make money selling beats online. The next thing I want to talk about is freelance services, because this is a route which you can go down niche or be quite broad on. You just got to know where it is you got to advertise your services. Now, for me, Fiverr was the breakthrough site that helped me get my main source of income as a music producer, and it's the thing I focused on the most for the first couple years as a producer. It took a while to build up, a good year again trying to build momentum. I had part-time jobs in the middle of it, and there's no shame in doing that. There is this weird narrative that does float around that to be a successful music producer, you have to have the time to do that and throw yourself in the deep end. If you have a full-time job, you need to quit that. No, you don't. In fact, it's really good to have a source of income, because if you want to invest in certain things like better equipment or in certain software or licenses or sites, for example, again, going back to beat making, you have to pay to get a subscription on BeatStars to upload into there. So it's good to have money in your pocket. But freelance sites was a really good one, because you can manage it in a way and you can take on as much work as you have available time. For me, I gave up a 5-day a week job and went to a 4-day a week job. So I had one day in the week to start selling freelance services, which was again was on Fiverr, even air gigs, and just making content on Instagram and making music, which eventually people would actually reach out if you're consistent enough with the content. But I found great success doing that. And again, it's what helped me go full-time freelance. And over time, over the course of 2 years, I found myself going from a 4-day a week job to a 2-day a week job when freelance really started to pick up, so I could have 3 days in the week. And eventually I quit that 2-day a week job altogether so I could be full-time freelance, because I had enough work coming in to be able to justify that. And all of a sudden, having that extra 2 days in a week not only allowed me to do all the freelance work, but start trying to think about what other sources of income I could actually have as a music producer. One of the hardest things about selling freelance services are actually the rates and how much you should charge. Now, the biggest bit of advice I give to that is make sure that you're not actually charging what you want to at the start, just slightly less, because you need to try and build up a little bit of a portfolio and try get regular customers in. So what you need to do is charge your rates slightly lower than your competitors, but also figure out who your competitors are. Now, I do actually believe that there's no competitors when it comes to making music. You know, all these producers, we're all in this together and we're not competing with anyone else, because your only competitor is yourself, to get cheesy for a second. But with that said, it's really interesting to look in the niche that you've chosen to pursue as a music producer. If you're pop, if you're trap, if you're R&B, have a look on freelance sites online on Instagram and try and find out how much people charge for services, because that gives you a good baseline of where to start. It also gives you a chance to go through their followings as well. Maybe you'll find some artists you can reach out to and try and collaborate with. But when you found out what that figure is at the start, just charge slightly less. Yes, you may not be feel like you're getting your money's worth for the time you're putting in, but again, you need to get that little bit of exposure and you need to start almost getting used to collaborating with artists, whether it's online or in person. Because as soon as you get into that rhythm, you get so much more confident with it and you start to learn the best ways to actually attract business. But don't focus so much on how much you're making per order, just focus on getting them orders in. And then as you start to build a reputation over time, that's when you can start charging more. Now, one more income I'll quickly touch on, which I do think could be a very good income for you, depending on what you do. If you're like a composer, if you like build up sort of the sort of music that you hear in trailers, adverts, or even just your beats as well, you can also do stock music or sync music licensing. Now, this is something which can be very daunting to get into if you don't know where to look. But again, it's just all down to doing the research, looking online, looking for sync libraries, and starting to build a catalog of music. And the biggest bit of advice I give you for this, if you want to pursue this, is to build up the catalog first before pitching. Give yourself the time to build up an extensive catalog of music which you can pitch to sound libraries, because I'm going to tell you now, no matter how good the music is, it's not always going to be accepted. In fact, some of my best beats and my best songs have been rejected by sites like Motion Array, Artlist, to name a few. But it doesn't mean it's not good. It just means that you got to have that sound bank, because you never know what someone's going to like or someone's going to want in their library. If you are going to do that as well, make sure that you are signed up to PRS so you can collect all your publishing royalties, or BMI if you are from the United States. I'm fortunate enough that I use BeatStars publishing for a lot of mine, which links up to Sony Score, and I've also got a PRS account as well. So for any reference to anyone who's from the UK, it kind of really covers the whole publishing thing. So I've got PRS for the UK, and then I've got BeatStars Publishing, which does very well for outside the UK. But the whole main premise of what I'm saying is you've got to find ways to monetize your music. And then that's the mindset you've got to have, because you can figure out how to monetize the music you're making. That's how you're going to start making the money. And I've just named three in this video, and I could go on. There's loads of incomes. A lot of them I don't even touch. We could talk about sample packs. We could talk about selling merch. We could talk about doing partnerships or endorsements on sites like YouTube or Instagram, growing a YouTube channel. But I don't want to overload you, because you need to decide what it is you want to do for yourself. And then once you've figured out what it is you want to do first, just go 100% in on that, because that's what's going to make you the most efficient and most likely to succeed at that one thing. The last thing I'll say, though, this is a little bit of a contradiction to what I've just said, but one of the most interesting things that I've learned from trying to make a full-time income as a music producer is the fact that I have tried to do different things at different points, whether it be try to make money from streaming, try to make money from selling beats, such and such, and it hasn't always worked out when I've done it. In fact, I've failed more times than I've succeeded as a music producer. I tried to do an artist career that completely tanked, didn't do so well with it, but then I used the content from that to help start a stock music licensing library and start to try and get sync placements. So again, it wasn't all for nothing. Beat selling as well took a little bit of time to actually get going, and I had to switch up the type of beats that I was making quite a lot until I found something that worked. Freelance services as well, I had to advertise about 5 to 6 different services before I found one which worked for me and started to actually get business and then repeat business. So when you get into something, just give it time and don't be afraid to change things up or mix things up if it's not going so well. Because again, sometimes it's just the little tweaks that can make the most difference, whether it be the certain sub niche that you're doing when it comes to making music, the type of service you're doing, the type of beat that you're making, or the type of libraries that you're pitching to. Whatever it is, you just got to give it time. And trust me, if you stick in it for the long term, it will work out for you. But yeah, guys, I hope you found this video helpful. I feel like I've rambled on for quite a lot. But hopefully there was substance to the rambling. If you did enjoy this video, make sure you smash the subscribe button, as there's a lot more videos like this on the way. Keep making music, and I will see you in the next video.